Hello and welcome to Verdant Works. Just like the engine men of old, we're in first thing in the morning before all the public are in to service this magnificent machine, the Boulton and Watt steam engine dating from 1801. Today we're going to start right up at the top on the first floor of the high mill and we're going to service the main beam of the engine. So here we are on the first floor of the high mill, ready to service the top of the steam engine. So I have this little ladder here that I can take up with me, and that allows me to get access to these two platforms where I can start servicing and looking at all the different bits of the motion work. So let's get on to that. So the first thing I'm going to do is take my trusty engineer's rag and just give the whole engine a little clean over. Once that's done, we can have a look at all the oiling points, and then we've got a very thick viscosity oil which clings to all the metal because this engine doesn't get run very frequently. The next thing to do is to just have a look and check that everything's nice and tight, because we use things called wedges in here, or known as drifts in engineering terms, and they wedge everything together and hold the machine nice and tight because this predates manufacturing of nuts and bolts. If we find a loose one, I have a piece of softwood and my trusty hammer, and we can just gently tap it to seat it back up. The final thing to do is to just take my spanner and check these two nuts at the back just to make sure they're not working loose. Now we can move on to the other side of the beam. Okay, so at the other end of the beam there's not much to do, there's just these four nuts up at the top, so I'm just checking to make sure they're nice and tight and clamped on the beam. I'm then going to take the TV rag and just give it a wee clean. And then finally, we just need to oil the bottom of the beam. And now we can go back down to the ground floor. Hello, so we're now up on the middle floor balcony of the engine, which gives me access to the cylinder and all the valve work. So this is probably the most complex part and the bit that needs the most in-depth attention looking at. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is actually work on the top of the beam again, but from this little bit of the platform. So there's two oil points just over to my left hand side, and we're going to take this, which is an oil gun, and just lubricate them, and that lubricates the main beam up at the very top. So, next step is to take the trusty rag again and we're going to clean all the motion work. So once we've cleaned everything, the next step is to check all the wee wedges again with our hammer and our block. So now it's just lubricating all the little oil holes. Right, so here we are at one of the main bearings, which connects the big flywheel to the electric motor that now powers this engine. So we just need to have a wee look at this, check all the nuts, make sure they're nice and tight still, take the trusty wee rag, give it all a wee clean. And then once that's done, we can take our wee oil can, just put a little bit of oil in the oil points. And then finally, this big flywheel is held on this square by being a slightly bigger square and having wedges that are driven into it to make it tight on the shaft. So we just do a little bit more percussive maintenance and check that they're nice and tight. And that's our service this bit. Right, so this is the business end of the bearing, and we've got the gear here, which operates the governor, and we've also got the two cogs on that side, and the cog that would have driven all the machinery when this worked in a bleach works. So again, first things first, we're going to take the rag and just give it all a wee clean. Next, we're going to take the spanner, and we're going to check the main gear bearing. Once they're nice and tight, we can then use the biggest spanner I have and check the main bearing. And just repeat that for the other side as well. We can take the wheel oil can and just oil the main points of the bearing. And also oil the main points on the ends of the crank as well. Now we just need to check the A-frame and we're all ready to run. So the final thing to do is just to tighten up these big nuts here that hold all the wooden A-frame together and support the weight of the engine. With that, we're ready to run. Thanks for watching. If you want more stories from inside Vernant Works and Discovery, please subscribe and follow us on our socials. We're going to show you a few shots of the engine running, and thank you very much for watching.